Hey, welcome back to Mr. Snack Hack. I'm your host, Mr. Snack Hack. And welcome back to part two of the great Easter jelly bean
extravaganza.
Review. Yeah.
So egg extravaganza.
If you didn't watch the previous episode, which you really missed out, this is where my expert here explained why she loves now jelly beans as an adult. And she's the one that actually facilitated this whole thing by carefully looking at some of the newest jelly bean options that are available at grocery stores and other department stores near you. Mm-hmm. So in this episode, we're going to try and review four flavors of jelly beans. We're going to give it a shot here, and hopefully our palates aren't so messed up that we can actually try it out. So
Sugar. We
start off with Swedish fish jelly beans, which didn't even know that they made these, but we're only going to put a couple out here because these look all identical to each other. There's not a lot of difference. And
basically Swedish fish.
Swedish fish.
If your kids like Swedish fish, you could put this in their egg.
I think this is going to be good. Here we go. Oh. Okay. So there's a little bit more here than just a standard jelly Swedish fish. It's got
more cherry to it.
Yeah, it's not fish flavored.
It's not fish flavored.
But it's got, I think it's in the candy coating. Mm-hmm. There's a kind of a cherry-ish, you're right, flavor to it. So it's not just like a straight up Swedish fish. There's something a little bit more to it.
Yeah.
I'm surprised, pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, more taste than I thought.
But I think if you buy a whole bag of these, it might get kind of old after a while.
That's a lot of cherry.
You really, really have to.
If you like cherry sour balls, though, you might really like these.
Yeah, agreed.
You know, those cherry.
So great flavor and nice little surprise there, but you got to think about buying a whole bag of those. All right, the next ones we have are the Jolly Rancher jelly beans. Now,
some of the Starburst ones were kind of hearkening toward the Jolly Rancher flavor.
In our previous episode, yeah. So here it looks like we've got about four different flavors, original flavors. It looks like a strawberry, an orange, watermelon, grape, blue raspberry, and green apple. So all of the most popular Jolly Rancher flavors looks like they're represented in these jelly beans.
Except orange. I'm confused about orange.
Have you never had an orange Jolly Rancher?
I have not had an orange Jolly Rancher.
Yeah, I can remember being much younger, and when I would end my paper route, I would go to a local drugstore that was near our house, and they had little tiny...
The little ones or the sticks?
They had both, but I would get the little ones just individually because that's all I could afford, and there was a lot of orange there. All right, which one did you try first?
Blue raspberry. That is exactly like a blue raspberry Jolly Rancher.
Okay, I'm going for what I think is green apple. Okay. And it's literally like the green apple Jolly Rancher, just a slightly different texture.
Garrett's going to like these.
The blue raspberry, he will, for sure. Mm-hmm. Now, watermelon is actually one of my favorite. Do these have all the flavors represented here?
There's watermelon.
Okay. All right, I'm going to try a watermelon. Oh, yeah.
I tried cherry. It tastes like a cherry.
So they got the chemicals mixed right here. Because clearly that's not a very natural watermelon or green apple flavor. Mm-hmm. But it is a very distinctive Jolly Rancher version of those flavors.
That's bizarre.
Okay, so I like this.
Yeah, these are great.
Only because I like the Jolly Rancher. Mm-hmm. So we don't want to cross-contaminate our jelly beans. So that's going over there.
Okay.
All right, you ready? Keep moving on?
Sure.
All right. Let's do... Sweetart Sour Jelly Beans. Now, we tried the Starburst Sours, and those were a big hit here in the house.
But Sweetart sort of has a market cornered on Easter candy, like I would say, with their little chicks and bunnies and...
Sweethearts?
Yeah, that's what Sweethearts are. And you suck on them, the shaped ones? Like, I haven't seen a lot of jelly beans that they have. But they're quite well known in the Easter candy space, right?
Yeah. They're usually more chalky, right?
Yeah.
So.
That's what I'm saying. So this is different.
Okay.
Ooh, that's a deformed
one. We got some mutant looking ones, which is great.
These are kind of like the nerd ones.
So very, very brightly colored.
That's a candy shell. That's a.
Yep. All right. Ready to try one out?
Yes.
Okay. Here we go. I'm going for what looks like orange.
They're soft, and I was expecting them to be hard. That was very weird.
That's exactly it. It was like, I was expecting a crunch, and it just, it's super soft
all
the way through.
They're chewy sweet tarts.
They are. You still get a little bit of that sweet tart, not chalkiness, that's kind of a rough term, but still really good.
Whoa.
Wow, that is sour. But the flavor fades really fast, and you still have the sort of the jelly bean interior.
That would say, I would say, is the difference. So they have chewy spree and chewy sweet tarts that are more like right. chalky, and this has a little bit of a jelly bean inside.
Yep.
But they're soft. That's so weird.
Yeah, that's pretty bizarre. But still, you know, that's good. Still good flavor.
Yep.
I prefer the Starburst sours mm-hmm. to the sweet tart sours.
But if you like sweet tart flavors, that's a good one.
Good one to go. All right. Last, we go to the king of the hill in terms of sour, and it is the Sour Patch Kids jelly beans. Five flavors: orange, red berry, blue raspberry, lime, and lemon, which corresponds quite easily to the flavors that you'd find in a normal Sour Patch
Kids. Now, these are sugar-coated like Sour Patch
yep.
Kids are.
So I'm guessing that's where this sour powder is on the outside. So not glossy in any way. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So it's literally like a Sour Patch Kid with just a slightly more dense coating on the outside.
Right, but the inside feels like the outside of a Sour
right.
Patch Kid. Like it's an inside-out Sour Patch Kid. That's sad.
Yeah. So I think if I was doing this, I'd probably just go get Sour Patch Kids.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
These aren't as messy, though, because there's not sugar to flake
off. Yeah, that's true. They've got a little bit of powder on the outside.
Yeah, but it's not like a Sour Patch Kid.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Chemically, these are... I don't understand how these were made, as well as the sweet tart.
Yeah. So it's approximating a Sour Patch Kid, mm-hmm. but not all the way there. And
but
so
it's good.
It's okay. I would rank, in terms of the sours,
mm-hmm.
I'd go Starburst.
Starburst.
Sweetart, and then Sour Patch Kids. Would you?
I think so.
Okay. All right.
So I like these.
So there you have it. I think we give, on the Swedish Fish, that's a thumbs up. You
right.
got to be careful. That's just a singular flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Jolly Rancher,
if you like Jolly Ranchers especially, you'll
super
love
good. Sweetart, thumbs up there. I think that was a good one, especially if you like those flavors. And Sour Patch Kids, for me, it was sort of a middling.
I think they're good. I really like Sour Patch Kids, though. So.
I do, too. And that's why I'm holding them up to a higher bar.
Oh.
Anyway, this has been the longest episode that we've ever recorded. Thank you for hanging in there. And come back for more Easter candy soon. Talk to you later.
Hi.
Bye.